Hello everyone, I have two things I'm going to cover in this video, including info on the next walkthrough, so sit tight. I finished all walkthrough projects up to this date, so needless to say that I'm looking to start another one soon. But that doesn't mean that I take requests. In fact, I don't take requests. Ever. I've never really covered it all that deeply though, I've just mentioned it here and there, so I'm gonna go into that a little bit more here. If I did take requests, problems would happen, which include, but are not limited to, on the flip side though, because I don't take requests, there's still some negativity towards me, which include, so as you can tell, no matter if I do requests or if I don't take requests, I'm... yeah. When I thought about it more, I came to the conclusion that when people request stuff without even asking if I take requests or anyone takes requests for that matter, it's just rude. For reasons that include, amazingly though, there are some people who know this, yet still request stuff in some way, shape, or form. They even sometimes scoot around my wording to try and get their request in. Well, I was going to cover all the ways they do this, but I think I would just come off as being rude or sarcastic, so I'll just say this.
I know what you are doing.
But okay, I think you get the idea by now why requesting stuff is actually a big deal. However, I understand the want to have some sort of say in the matter or some sort of interaction, so I think I've come up with a reasonable compromise for this. I decided to bring back voting for the next walkthrough, which is something that I did way back in the early days of my channel. Here, I have two games that I'm willing to play next. Keyword though, willing. Willing. The first game is of course Donkey Kong Country 3, which is the obvious choice since I just finished 2, and it would complete the series of Donkey Kong Country SNES games. Plus, it's a pretty dang good side-scroller. I'd also aim for 105% as an added challenge by inputting a code that is actually in the game to remove checkpoint barrels and Donkey Kong barrels too. The second game is Super Mario 64, yet another game that has been as elusive to me to make a walkthrough on as Kirby 64 was, in that my recording limitations prevented me from doing it. It of course would be a walkthrough of all 120 stars, and I'd have an organized menu system similar to Super Mario Sunshine. There are a few rules to the voting though, just to make this a little bit easier. Three, in fact. Number one, one vote for one game by one person. Obviously, otherwise someone could just spam. Number two, votes have to be comments in this video. The reason why is just for ease of counting. Number three, there will be a voting deadline, of which I'll add in at the end of this video because I don't know when this video is going to be finished. That's all the rules there are, so feel free to vote now while you have the chance. I'll post a comment in the comments below indicating the deadlines and on this video when it hits the deadline, so you'll know the cutoff between comment timelines, basically. If there's some sort of tie, what I'll do is I'll extend the deadline by a day and keep doing so until the tie is broke by the end of the tiebreaker day, or days. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later!